Oh my god, it's Kendall and Kylie.
Hey guys, welcome back to the Entertainment Lab. I'm back with season 1 recap of Trinkets. So without wasting time, let's jump right into it. And before that, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon.
Yo, Brady. What the fuck you doing?
LED, a shockingly talented shoplifter, has moved to Portland after growing up in Albuquerque. The reason for her move is a tragic one, the sudden death of her mother, Mara. After an unexplained incident in New Mexico following Mara's death, LED's dad has decided she needs to live with him. He still worried LED's after she is caught shoplifting, so he sent her to Shoplifters Anonymous. There she meets Mo and Tabitha. Mo is a weed-smoking wise ass with perfect eyeliner, where Tabitha is a popular girl whom Mo has a long and thorny history with. Tabitha is wealthy, but sad, likely due to her boyfriend, Brady.
Alright, used to be more fun.
You used to be less of a dick.
Hey.
LED wants to go to Albuquerque for her girlfriend Joey's birthday party. So she sells the jacket to a guy who eventually scams her and ran away. At least, Tabitha and Mo are there to support Elodie at that moment. Still, Tabitha and Mo ends up at Paper Tiger for their own lonely reasons. Tabitha heads to the club after realizing her hot date with Brady is actually a group hang with his annoying friends. On the other hand, Elodie and Joey aren't dating. She lied. Tabitha and Mo throw their support around Elodie. Meanwhile, Tabitha continues to grapple with Brady's bad behavior. In an effort to find a little bit of happiness, Tabitha heads to the Paper Tiger to see Luca. She kisses him, but he rejects her, saying he doesn't want to be a part of her high school drama. It breaks Tabitha's heart. Oh, and Tabitha's dad is cheating on her mom.
Oh, fuck. That's not your mom.
Tabitha celebrates her 17th birthday at a lavish party cruise, but is unable to forget the family secret she has discovered. With Tabitha trapped with her parents and Brady on the boat, Mo and Elodie are free to know each other back on land. To get away from their respective family problems, Elodie and Mo go to the party at what appears to be an abandoned warehouse. Elodie kisses a girl, but Mo rejects a former hookup after seeing Nova's I'm a Lemming Instagram post. Back there, Brady hacked Tabitha's Instagram and share a photo of her in her underwears with a caption, "Big mistake." With one disturbingly manipulative move, Brady has bullied Tabitha. Elodie and Mo are equally upset, especially since Brady refused to give Tabitha her grandfather's watch. So, the girl decides to break into his car and steal it. They got the watch, but also steals the car. Tabitha has told them that Brady mistreats her, and after that, they threw his car in the lake. Now we know about how Elodie's mother Mara died. She died in the car accident. This was the reason Elodie was so freaked out by driving Brady's car. As for Mo, she received a call from his father. She got confused and texted Noah, who ignores her message, and later Mo sees him with her ex. So she got angry and pushes him away again.
Why don't you just go find some chill girl to take to the dance and just leave me alone?
Elodie, Tabitha and Mo plans to hit up a party at Luca's and Sabine's home. Sabine ignores Elodie throughout the party because she saw Luca and Elodie kissing. Meanwhile, Mo also was making out with the boy, but he sees the face of Noah and instantly goes to him to tell that she may love him. And after, she also told that she lied about her shoplifting secret. She never did that. Not only do Elodie and Tabitha feel betrayed, but Mo's explanation makes her sound like a tourist in their plan. Elodie texts Sabine and they met for a coffee. After that, they went for a walk where Sabine asked Elodie to steal sunglasses for her, which she did, but eventually got suspicious of her. Meanwhile, Mo got the good news that she got the STEM program in Korea. She wants to share this news with Noah, who told her that he and Kyla hooked up last night, which really breaks her heart. Meanwhile, Tabitha's days were looking good as she was flirting with Luca. After making out, Tabitha left for her home where she found Brady and got angry with her mom. After learning that Mo lied about the shoplifting, Munity is stuck between three girls, Tabitha is going to accept Mo, but the things are different with Elodie. Meanwhile, Mo's mother is very happy to find out about Korea, and Noah surprises Mo with beautiful cherry blossoms. But back at Elodie's home, we see Spencer playing with a toy on Elodie's dad's suitcase. For now, everyone is too content to worry about what Elodie's passion for illegal behavior really means. She has Sabine and is so happy about it. Mo is finally settled in with Noah, then the crack begins to show. When Elodie goes to see Sabine, the singer reveals she is going on a tour starting tomorrow. Sabine wants Elodie to join her, but seems to forgetting about a little thing called school. Whereas Brady approaches Tabitha to accuse her of stealing his car and pushing it into the lake. So Brady blackmails Tabitha on becoming his girlfriend again. Tabitha's angry, but her friends try to save her. Elodie confesses to the crime and Mo punches Brady in the face.
Oh my god, it's Kendall and Kylie.
Only Mo sees true consequences from this disaster. Since he is suspended by hitting Brady, Mo's admission to the Korean STEM program is revoked for the suspension. These quick twists are usually enough drama for the finale. But Doug also finds Elodie's stash suitcase. Inside of the luggage is a key to Brady's car, which confirms she was involved in Grand Theft Auto. Doug decides Elodie needs to go to an inpatient recovery center for her addiction. Mo acts as the distraction while Tabitha breaks into Elodie's room using a ladder to get her out of the house. Soon enough, they are running to a getaway car and heading to that bridge from the cold open. It's there Elodie throws Brady's car key, the last piece of evidence that can connect the girl to the theft. Then, she, Tabitha and Mo say their final emotional goodbye. After a long group hug, Elodie runs to Sabine's touring van for a new adventure. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like it, hit the like button, and for more such content like this, subscribe to our channel.